I don't feel like 60. Family gathered to celebrate my birthday at the beautiful beaches resort and spa on the Caribbean island of Provinciales. This is a luxurious resort with 7 miles of white sand beach, 6 pools, 22 acres of lush gardens, 7 restaurants, and every imaginable activity, including, of course, scuba diving. Located about 600 miles southeast of Miami, Turks and Caicos is one of the last remaining British Crown colonies. The name comes from early explorers who thought that the scarlet blossom on the local cactus resembled a Turkish fez, and Caicos comes from the Spanish word piquis. This family-friendly resort caters to children of all ages, with 3 kids camps geared to infants, young children, and teens. Rachel lives in New York City and is finishing up her PhD dissertation in anthropology. This year, she will be teaching at the new school. Sue is a client relationship manager for Brinson Partners, an asset management firm. She recently took up golf, but prefers to lounge on the beach with a good book. Arlene is director of Crisis Link, a regional crisis prevention center. Having appeared on TV several times, she was honored by Tipper Gore at a recent White House ceremony. Steve is a senior sales engineer for Access Line Communications and is an active musician playing bass, keyboards, singing, and composing. Ben attends the University of Virginia, studying bioethics and philosophy. He is trained in mountain rescue and loves chess, water polo, and scuba diving. Eric teaches and plays guitar in the San Francisco area and hopes to make a record this year. His hobbies include reading, playing with the dog, and making babies. Lauren is a third grade teacher, matching Eric's hobbies. They plan to move to Massachusetts during the summer of 2001. Madison is 8 months old and just loves to crawl around the house and on top of Miles, their 90-pound lab. Taylor will be 3 in May. She loves to sing, count, recite the alphabet, hike with Miles, and spend endless hours looking at her fish tank. Bob retired from a long career at the Homewack Hotel in Ellenville, New York, and now spends time playing golf and dominoes. Sherry also retired from the Homewack Hotel and loves to work out. They split their time between homes in Florida and New York. Tavia, an active equal rights advocate, was appointed as Executive Director of Lawyers for One America by Bill Clinton. She spoke at the UN in March 2000. Allen is Director of Tax Planning for Cisco Systems. Just certified as a scuba diver, he is looking forward to a second career as a history buff. Zach attends the Del Mar Middle School, where he plays tennis, basketball, and baseball. He is training for his bar mitzvah this August. Aaron is in his third year at the Branson School. His hobbies include playing lacrosse, acting in stagecraft, and now scuba diving. Bruce is general manager of the world's largest pogo stick manufacturer. His hobbies include skiing, restoring vintage cars, and tinkering. Lori teaches kindergarten in a small town in upstate New York. She enjoys skiing, working out, and loves to drive Bruce's old cars. Stephen attends college and has a gift for art, guitar playing, and according to Bruce, for attracting women. Malcolm is a freelance visual artist, creating logos for Broadway plays, websites, and video presentations. He loves cruising his motorcycle with his woman. Elizabeth is a clinical psychologist with a downtown New York practice. After one resort dive, she is hooked and will become certified in the near future. Deb retired from a career at Crate and Barrel, trading many demanding customers for one very demanding but loving child. Mitchell's firm, EC Now, provides courses on internet commerce at San Jose State, Comdex, and other venues. He has published two books, with more on the way. Duncan will be three in May. He loves life and has established himself as the center of life at Nancy Court in Cupertino, California. Fred retired from a successful high-tech career and spends time swimming, hiking, traveling, diving, and making wildlife videos. And I retired 4 years ago from Intel. I love to work out, knit, hike, swim, cook, play tennis, travel, dive, and interact with my grandchildren. Many of us took advantage of the activities offered here at Beaches, especially the water sports. Rachel was the only one to try the water slides, making a lovely splash in the pool. Last-minute scheduling resulted in an early evening ride on a parasail for Ben. Although Ben got his ride on the parasail, several of us did not when the boat ran out of fuel. Malcolm to the rescue. However, most of the time the family looked to more sedentary activities. have 9 certified divers in our group, and Alan finished his open water certification this weekend at Fiji.
Congratulations, Alan.
Now, tell us what you think about scuba diving.
Well, you see a lot of fish.
So let's go diving and cruise the coral-encrusted walls that make Turks and Caicos one of the premier dive locations in the Caribbean. This friendly great barracuda is about 4 feet long and very photogenic. He is waiting under the dive boat, hoping that someone will bring him a mid-morning snack. Eagle rays are perhaps the most graceful of all the underwater animals, and we were fortunate to get this nice footage. Only the tail and eyes of this southern stingray are visible. We have disturbed his lair, so off he goes to find another one. This 5-foot nurse shark is not very happy that we disturbed his morning sleep and goes off to find a more peaceful location. The octopus is often very hard to find since it changes its skin coloring to blend into its surroundings. This one has been discovered and needs to find another resting spot. The flounder is another master of disguise, finding rocks that match his coloring. Note that both eyes are on the same side of his head. Hi, guys.
Happy birthday, Peggy.
Bubbles and I came all the way from California to wish you a happy birthday.
Yeah, and I came from the South Pacific. I'm really tired.
Anyway, it was great seeing you. We're going to look around a bit before we head back tomorrow.
Dinners were the time for the family to get together after a hard day at the pool. Food is a very important part of our family culture, and the beach's resort did not disappoint us. Duncan was my assistant in opening the presents I received, some from groups and some from individuals. Yes, this was a great 60th birthday party and one that I will always remember. Thanks for joining me, and I hope to see you all again at the next big, wonderful event.